Hello fellow tankers, in this video I will present you some strategic tips on the Carpathians map, and then I will show you a gameplay with the new Swedish tanks. So this Carpathians map is a horizontal map, in my definition of horizontal map, in the sense that the three caps are at equal distance from each other. From the two spawns. If you have watched some of my videos, you know that in many horizontal maps, generally you have two connected caps on which you should concentrate your efforts. This Carpathians map is pretty original in the sense that the three caps are actually pretty isolated. It's very difficult to navigate from one cap to the other. And so you have essentially three independent battles, but actually not completely independent, since you will see that it's actually possible to shoot from A to C, from B to C, from B to A, and conversely. But it's in practice pretty hard to go from A to B or B to A, and let's say dangerous, but not impossible to go from B to C or C to B. Let me first address the repartitions of the team in the beginning of the game. So we will see that A is a very important cap, so typically 8 tanks should go there from each team. On B, no more than 2 tanks should go there, but you will see that B is still a quite important cap, and the rest of the two teams, that is typically 6 tanks, should go there. For me, that would be the ideal repartition of forces between the three caps. So let me just first address A. So from the red side, you can go this way and then enter this area, and you can also try a flanking maneuver which will allow you maybe to shoot from here or even to surprise your enemy. From the green side, you can try a shortcut approach in the beginning of the game, but I find that the fastest way to go to A is actually to take the bridge, which will allow you not to have to climb this area, which some tanks will have a lot of difficulties to climb. So on A, the fight is pretty straightforward. I mean, you have some the grounds here are a bit lower, you have some obstacles. Again, at least one or two tanks could try to flank here, especially in RB, for instance, from the green side. But the fight is pretty straightforward. The interest of A, if you can control it, is that, for instance, the green side can advance here and shoot at B. You can even shoot at some, not everywhere, but at some people in the area of C. Same from the red side, so you have to find a good position. And honestly, instead of aiming at the enemy spawn, for instance, the red side trying to aim at the enemy spawn, or the green side aiming at the enemy spawn, my advice is that you really concentrate on, if you control A, to clean as much as you can around B and C. So B is quite important because if you control B, you can actually shoot at tanks going to A from both sides. And you can actually hamper the arrival of reinforcement to A. So B is actually quite important. But the reason that not too many tanks should go to B is that you know, essentially you don't have enough room for more than two tanks to fight efficiently on B. If you are more than two tanks, you will just step on each other's feet. So my advice is that typically two tanks go there. So the terrain on B is favorable to the to the red side. You have a very safe approach here, and you can come on B and cap very easily. From the green side, it's a bit more delicate. I'm advising you to come from the north of B and to settle at this corner here, which is pretty safe, but be careful because you may be seen by some people on C. You can also see them, so you can actually take a pause here and shoot people arriving around C in this area actually. But you have to be a bit careful, and then you can attack maybe the one or two tanks which would be on the cap. From B, on B, from the green side, if you capture B, my advice is that you don't stay at this corner because, again, you may be vulnerable from this area, but that you push a bit and that you use this rock. You can even go almost, it's pretty aggressive, almost up to this rock. But definitely use rocks and dead tanks to pass B and then to cover the access to the hills and the exit of the red spawn. From the red side, just stay on B. You have a good cover and you can essentially shoot at people coming this way, which is not a very good approach, honestly, or shoot at imprudent people going to A, especially if they don't want to take the long way. If they take a bit of a shortcut, you will see them from B and you will be able to shoot at them. So my advice is that you take you go on B with a good gun, which is still efficient at let's say medium distance. There is the access to B is pretty fast, and there is no problem to go on B with an heavy tank. It's, I like to go on B with Tigers or tanks, tanks like that. As for the fight on C, very often I find the teams too passive, and I find that there are not enough people behind C generally. For instance, this area behind C, not in the main street here, but behind C here, is actually pretty safe, and very often it's actually possible to cap C, but nobody is capping C. It's sometimes a bit annoying. So for the red side, very often the red side, unfortunately, just stays in this area, which is really too passive. The red side should really try to push to this area and even to this area and cap. And the reason why the red side should push is that the green side has a good strategy, either going the long way here or even the short way here, which is for the green side to occupy this area. So if you have green tanks, one or two green tanks here, it's very, very annoying because any tank which would leave from that corner would be really in danger of being shot in the back. And that's why the red side should, when they, in the beginning of the game, when they come out from their spawn, they should not stop here. Okay, something that you see in most games, they should really try to push as far as they can, not necessarily cap C immediately, but push as far as they can to first prevent the green tanks to be here, which would be really very annoying. Essentially, your only choice would be to kill them with bombers or CAS. but also to secure the area of sea. And again, if you hold sea, you have to be careful of people shooting from A, definitely. They have an advantage, they have a better cover, they are in the higher ground, so don't necessarily camp them. You can actually push toward the enemy camp, and use a position which is also good for green tanks, which is in this area, where you can shoot toward the B, and also shoot at people who would be on the edge of the hill on A, quite with, let's say, reasonable cover. So let me summarize. The main cap is definitely A, whatever the BR. Of course, the higher the BR, the more dangerous will be people then camping from A. So definitely at the higher BRs, you have really to not to let the enemy to be too cozy on A. But as I mentioned, B, which is very very often neglected, is very important. I very often go to B, especially from this side where the terrain is favorable, but also very often from the other side. And I usually get very good results on this map by going to B. And again, from the green side, to be a bit more aggressive than from the red side, because just staying here is not very effective or even very safe because of red tanks here. Whereas if you push a bit and use the nice cover that you have in this area, you can actually really threaten the exit of the red spot. As for C, again, especially for the red side, but also for the green side. The green side should also try to fight for this area, and the green side should also exploit this nice shooting spot here. So don't be too passive. Very often, I find the fight for C extremely passive. It's actually not even so dangerous to cap C. Actually, you will find that capping C, you are essentially safe from. You have many safe positions from people, enemies on C, and sometimes the most dangerous people that you, for you, will be actually people shooting from A. But if the two sides are still fighting for A, you will generally not have people shooting at C. But again, if a side has completely control A, then you have to be very careful. Then the spawn and the other caps are really in danger. So S is still the main cap. Okay, so now we will move to the replay. And I'm playing the Swedish lineup at 6-7-7-0, meaning that I have three tanks, one at 7-0, the Whoosh, which I will be playing, and the STRV-81, which is a Centurion Mark III, which is a pretty good tank, and the IKV-91, which is not bad, which has a gun which is not very easy to handle, but ETFS, which is a bit capricious, but it's actually for me the best mid-tier lineup in Sweden, because the problem of Sweden is that you will find that you can make a lineup very easily up to 3.0. You have an excellent lineup in top BR and in the 9.0-10.3 range. But between 3.0 and 9.0, you have very few tanks and very few good tanks, a lot of bad tanks. And let me just mention the very few good tanks, the PVKV 2, 3.7 very fun tank, the Delat Tourne at 5.0, but which is completely alone, that you will have to play with 3.7 and maybe even 3.0 tank. or the 3.7 line premium tank, which I have, which is very good, but which already to fight at 5.0 is maybe not powerful enough. The 6.7.7.0 lineup that which I'm playing now is definitely the most coherent lineup. The 7.7 lineup is kind of a nightmare. I mean, you have the STRV 101, which is a Centurion Martin, which is an okay tank, but already, honestly, not that good at BR-77 because of its bad mobility, and it has essentially the same shells as the 6.7 tank. And the horrible STRV 103, which is a piece of brown baguette, if you pardon my French, which is completely bugged, which is essentially unplayable. And then you don't have any third tank, you have to play one of these tanks that I'm playing here, 7.0 or 6.7. So the 7.7 lineup, unfortunately, is very bad. And so far I'm stuck with it, I'm playing it, but I am having a bad result. And it's not only my fault. And I have no idea how I will grind the top BR lineup because the 7.7 lineup is so bad. So I guess I will grind it at I will grind it at 7.0 BR. So here I'm using my Hoosh, which has a bit which can be killed by any machine gun, any artillery exploding at 100 meter. So usually I told you that I'm going to be, but this Hoosh guns are not very well adapted for B, I guess. I mean, that was my guess, so I'm going to A. So the Hoosh has a gameplay a bit similar to the R3. They are both as fragile, but they are fun tanks. The Hoosh is not as fast. So here you see the hill I was talking about. It's not, too, especially in RB, not always very easy to climb it. So I'm taking a very aggressive stance with this Hoosh. I use it in the beginning of the game when there is no planes, because any planes will kill you, any RT will kill you. So I'm spraying a lot of shells on this Jag Panther and kills it. So you have two guns. You should have separate controls for the two guns. They have nine shells each. Arcade, it takes 45 seconds to reload each gun. Unfortunately, in RB, you need a cap to reload. So this thing is actually maybe more effective in RB. I played it in RB, it was pretty fun. The only problem is that when you have no shell left, you need to go to a captured zone. So sometimes you don't have any captured zone, so you are in a big trouble. And even if you are in a capture zone, the problem is that very often I died due to artillery while reloading my shells. So here there is artillery, so I'm moving at once, and I'm going to see what's happening on B. It's not very easy to drive, and here I suddenly realized that half of the enemy team sees me. I have no idea how I survived this machine gun from 300 meters. You can be killed by 50 cal from 300 meters. Hein? So my tank is a bit broken. I don't have any shell, so I'm reloading. But I'm going to be, because my teammates are doing a good job. So let me just take a break here to show you what's happening. You see this guy shooting at these red tanks, these guys. So here, I mean, obviously in this game you will see the red team was not aggressive enough. And so you see here where I am capping B from this side, it's pretty safe, but you have to be a bit careful and also look at people from C. But you see that here your view is not very good from the two people emerging from the spawn. Well, you can see a few, as you can see. We'll kill these two SPG, which are not in a very good position. But my advice is that you push a bit toward the rocks which are in front, which will give you in general a better view of the red tanks going to the hills, whereas really from the green side, from the red side, the terrain here is much more favorable. So here, my poor colleague on my left was killed, I think, by artillery. My tanks is a bit survived that. I have no idea. I think I was pretty lucky in this game. And you will see that I have been actually very, very, very lucky in this game. So let me accelerate a bit. I'm repairing. And I am spending a huge amount of shells on these tortoises. It's not very easy to aim. You don't have, as you see, you don't have even in arcade any marker. But on some tanks, this. Shells, these rockets can really work. Another problem with this tank is that you cannot destroy any obstacles if you even the weakest obstacles, so you have to sometimes to shoot at them, and so that's the end of the game, and we are pinning them in their spawn again when three caps are captured. The enemy is nowhere close to any cap. Well, I mean, let's just shorten their suffering, which is what I'm doing here. And that's my last kill. I have very few. Very few rockets left, none left now, and I am kind of rammed by one of my squad mates, and I want to be survivor, so I'm leaving the area to survive this game, and a good game without dying with this Yush, which is really a challenge, with 7 kills, 5 assists and 2 caps, and a good score. And as you will see, I will be rewarded by Gadjin. Just after this game, I received a talisman for the Yush, so I think I will play the 7-0, 6-7, 7-0 lineup, which is pretty good. No topi, seriously, but pretty good to grind my higher BR tanks, and honestly, I will give up a bit the 7-7 lineup. So thank you for watching. I hope that I hope that you enjoyed these strategic tips on this interesting and old map, where the three caps are three different battles, essentially. It's very difficult to navigate from one cap to the other, even if, as you saw in this game, I actually went from the hills to B. But in general, it's pretty rare to go from one cap to the other. But this map is also interesting because you can shoot from one cap to the other. So I invite you also to consult my tutorials on the forum. And see you in battle.